Faceoff win and skated out here by Jensen. Look out! Big hit! Whoa! Kronwalled! And of course it was a clean hit, and the Islanders will come over to answer for it, as down is their top goal scorer and point getter, Anders Lee, who just got Kronwalled. Whoa, what a hit.
Well, usually it's at the other blue line. Very rarely do you ever get Kronwalled at the Detroit blue line.
And he's cut. I don't know where the visor came up and caught him.
Well, they're right below us, Ken, and I couldn't tell where the contact was made.
I saw that one coming, and Kronwall had him in his sights. His head was down, and a clean hit, and no arm in the air from the officials that there was anything dirty about it. And Lee obviously will go off. And even last night when Kronwall, or two nights ago when Kronwall hit Matthews, wanted to be sure even that Matthews is okay. It's not like they want to anybody injured.
Lee's got his head down, the puck's in his feet. That's a dangerous thing. Where is the contact? Oh, yeah, yeah. I don't like the look of that at all. I don't like the look of that at all. At all. Contact initially looked like it was in the head of that replay, which that'll get looked at from Toronto without anybody saying anything. So that's what happened.
No, they're kid. Looking at it. When I look at that,
yep.
Lee has bent over.
Yeah, but
Kronwall's committed to the hit. But as Lee comes down to look at the puck, his head comes down with it. Kronwall can't stop in that instance.
Well, I'm not questioning any of that. I'm just telling you, that replay, the contact initially hit the head. And that's what they'll look at primarily to go forward or not.
It depends whether position of player was changed and if Kronwall changed his position and could have avoided it.
That's right.
If Kronwall is already committed to the hit and Lee is there and no position is changed,
there's a lot that goes into determining penalties, suspensions, etc. on a hit like this. A lot. So,
The Department of Player Safety reviews every hit in every game.
Right. I mean, this could be anything from nothing to a 2-minute penalty to a 5-minute penalty in a game misconduct. You don't know. But at least they got together and talked about it and saw.
I don't think there's anything wrong with it, to tell you the honest truth, but. And I'd say that up the other way. Barry Trotz is saying that was a hit to the head. It certainly wasn't targeted, and it's where Lee's body is in that position. Now, watch it here. Kronwall did not change any position, and Lee keeps skating with his head down right into it. Kronwall did not come off the ice. He did not lean up into his head. He did not target his head.
No, he didn't, but the shoulder hit the head. That is what they look at.
And depending on position of the player's body and what was changed. Kronwall's bending down. If Lee did not bend over, he hits him square in the chest.
True. I'm not debating any of that.
Kronwall's stationary and Lee runs into
it. You've got head contact made, now figure it out. So you can't question the head contact. It was there. So, like I said, it could be nothing to.
There are circumstances where the head contact is unavoidable. Now, if you're playing international rules, there's any contact with the head, you're out, regardless.
Well, that's kind of silly.
Playing in Europe. Well, they may come to this league one day.
Yeah, I hope not.
But there is no penalty on that play.
There you go.
Yep. And again, further, the league will look at it, sure they will, and they'll decide to do nothing or do something, and who knows.
That's a good thing.